I tell you what, it's bloody hot right now. I am sweating in my chair. TMI, man. TMI. Shut up. Look, I'm pretty sure it's raining, or has been. So it's humid. It's warm as all hell, and I'm trying to decide what to do in this episode. In the last episode, we escaped by the skin of our teeth, despite Sir Jairus becoming abusive and Mr. Steve becoming paranoid. We should probably send Sir Jairus in as well, but I think... No, nothing, nothing to prevent him from going in... Oh, won't drink, apparently. Teetotal? No? Yeah, resolution. Well... Fine. But don't do it again. So now we're poor. What do we do? I mean, honestly, we took a... We did an antiquarian mission with a healer. And we still failed. So maybe it wasn't to be. Let's see what the options are. I want to get more money to level people up in terms of equipment before we try any of these bosses. There's an Apprentice Warren's mission, which is basically... Ooh, an Apprentice Skirmish in the Ruins is actually even more perfect for the party that we were going to take in the last episode, but chose not to because the only option was the cove and we didn't have anything that could do the blight damage that we need to get through the cove properly, nor did we have anything that could heal the damage that's likely to happen in the cove. So... we avoided that, but now we've got some level 1 missions and we can start leveling up Erasmus, Homesy, Darktrojan and Adam here. This is not very good, but we should actually have a look at these. Let's bring these back and sort by name. And see if we've got any duplicates of stuff that we just never use, like this. Yes. Yes. This is very rare. But I'm never going to use it. This is actually turning out to be quite lucrative. We're going to get another one of these, but I'm not going to sell it right now. We're going to keep our Hellion trinkets for reasons previously mentioned. We don't need to move stones. Good. Now we've got one of everything I care about. I mean, I could get rid of more. Still haven't really decided what, so I'm not actually going to. We will sort by class restriction and start applying them to people. DT, you're going to be taking... Probably move resist seems like a good idea, because if DT gets out of order, everything goes wrong. It's basically imperative that DT remains at the front, except when Erasmus has taken the front position. At which point, it's important that he's in that position and nowhere else. So that has to stay. No. Homesy, you will take the decent trinkets that make everything trivial, except how nothing apparently is trivial. We'll take this so that we can do the usual dancing around majiggery. Like, 3 speed after the first round is pretty bad, but the first round buffs are so good. We can just take out a unit normally if we do, if we get lucky enough, which is not more likely. More move resist, more stun skill. I'm not really using those. I think we explained that in the last episode, actually. So what we're going to be looking at in the ruins is either holy or human. Probably don't want this. And then on Adam here, we have a couple of whistles. We've got this, which I'm not really using, but kind of want a bleed skill chance on this unit because whenever we're not up against skeletons, being able to bleed what's left is great. Below 51 is not something I'm going to be doing. More dodge, more speed. I quite like that one. The debuff resist is not brilliant, but we can often sort of deal with it. There's another duplicated there. How did I not see this? Versus beast. There's not much beast in the ruins. There are some. Not many. Not much eldritch. Maybe there's a bleed amulet somewhere. Yeah. That seems good. Okay. But before we provision and then get salty, we're going to put these four in the blacksmith. We already did this last episode, didn't we? And decided not to take them, which is where all our money went. We'll also put them in the guild. Please, let me click on the guild. Fine. We want that. What's the bonus on this? Less prop. Not too big a deal right now, I think. More damage on that. We're not really using... Oh, we do use this, don't we? Because the knockback is huge. We're likely to use that and that. And then Homesy, I'm just going to upgrade your two healing skills. This is the one that's negative dodge, but you have to be in the third position, which is fine, actually. Quite like Illumination, when there's likely to be dodgy things, like those bastards on the previous one, that has such high dodge that we couldn't actually hit them for several rounds. And there was one at the back that we couldn't hit at all, etc, etc. So, but again, I think we're going to a low... Because we're going to a low-level guild... going to a low-level ruins, it's not actually that important that we have that particular thingy. So Shadow Fade and Lunge are going to be upgraded, and Pix of the Face is going to be upgraded. The other two can wait. We're not going to be doing any camping, so we're just going to go for this. There's possibility that we might want to take, you know, more skills, but they're not going to be useful right now, and that's why I'm not taking them. We want to come back with as much as possible, so I've taken two keys. If we find a secret room, that would be brilliant. Yeah, I'll take one of these. Maybe we get debuffed too much. Maybe we find a food table, which would help in the situation where we suddenly discover that we've already had three hungers in this tiny little place. And what better place to begin? Not impossible. Could still happen. 100% of room battles, so we do have to visit every room, or at least rooms we know about. We might as well do everywhere anyway, because we would like to collect stuff. This is, it's a torch. Seriously, it's a torch. You had to take all your bloody time, didn't you? That happens quite frequently, that the first thing we find is a torch. I don't know if it's that... knew about the trap, was talking. I don't know if it is some sort of confirmation bias that I always seem to notice when the first thing is a torch, but it does happen quite often. Okay. We'll move to this room battle. We did bring a couple of spades. One of them was free because we brought the grave digger.
Cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
The battle is basically trivial. We will lunge. Kill the first one. You can do anything from either position, which is why we take you. This is a really good party, in my opinion. I'm super happy with it. As long as we have the quick draw trinket. If I would start a new campaign, I would have no idea how to play, because all of the strategies that I've developed with these characters basically rely on certain trinkets. Like in this situation, this thing could quite easily dodge me. 90%. There's a 10% chance that this goes wrong.
Another abomination cleansed.
That's in the way. That's a problem. Again, we can't actually hit the back, which is a... But, well, this unit can. Maybe we should do that? Mark this one. Let's check this. Damage plus marked. So if we mark this, Adam can hit it. Should kill it, provided it doesn't dodge. Bit of stress to start with, but that's fine.
Back to the pit.
Don't know if that was guaranteed. I didn't check the actual damage, but it is what it is. We only have the less dodge and the self-heal, which we could do with, so let's just do that. 7 damage and 5 heal. Doesn't do any extra damage versus holy, which surprises me. I would have expected the Vestal, much like the Crusader, to have a bonus against holy, but it doesn't. I mean, we could just pick to the face. Why not, right? Not guaranteed to kill. Good enough chance I'm prepared to take it against the guarantee kill here.
Yeah,
there was a reasonable chance that went wrong. But there was also a reasonable chance that they both got a go before me. And then we didn't have enough... I don't know. Just seemed like a good idea. Don't judge me. We don't need to go there. There's a battle on the way. I mean, if we're feeling okay at the end, we'll go there. How about that? I was just thinking about food. hoping that we'd have enough to get back if it turned out to be necessary. 100, 100, 110, 90. 70, sorry. Okay. We will make sure to use the most likely thing, unless somebody is so badly off that they could do with a tiny little bit of stress relief that you get from it, which is quite unlikely. Yes, no battle here. We know what's happening. We've scouted the hallway. There is no secret room. Hopefully, therefore, there is a use for our key. There is. We can start exchanging all these, the huge amount of crests that we're getting, for portraits and things like that that we actually need. I might have to get rid of Adam's curiosity.
Now it must be carried home.
Because it could turn out to be extremely inopportune. Does this work with a key? Maybe holy water? Surprised, you say? Now this is a time I'm happy to see surprised. Because we can actually genuinely kill most of these things. As soon as we start. You're the only one who can hit that, but I don't know what your damage is. It doesn't say what the damage of the thing is, it just says when it has more damage, so I think we mark it just in case that is required to put Adam's damage over the top. So that's going to be 9 to 14, so we should have. And a crit of 20 is great. Gets rid of some of Homesy's stress, which is brilliant. And I'm wondering if we try to, can't actually stun it. Have you got any dodge? No. So what's our highest damage then? 4 to 9. Click, please, thank you. 3 to 6, yeah, just do that. We can crit again and get 13. I'm happy with that as well. So, yep, this is all going to happen. That is... I wouldn't have minded you moving backwards, to be fair. Pick to the face is going to be what? 9 to 8? Ooh, that could do most of the damage we need it to do. So we shall do that. 10. Okay. Because 25 versus human. Again, could kill it. Did kill it. We don't need to ensure that Erasmus gets back to this position. We only need to ensure that Homesy ends up in this position at the start, which is why Erasmus has the quick draw trinket in the first place. There is an obstacle here. So we don't need to go that way, so it doesn't do nothing. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. I genuinely meant to say that the way I did. Keith. Whatever. Just eat it. Just open it. We can go back, so I will. I want to get as much out of this as I can. Which basically involves using... going to these curios and collecting all the stuff and chucking away inventory that's not going to be valuable and using it on inventory that is valuable. So we'll go here. Might as well do this other battle. We've been doing really well. Happy to beat some more stuff up and we'll get the loot. The drops from it. It's nice every now and then to have more surprise. Brilliant. It's nice every now and then to get a run that's just basically trivial for you. Guaranteed, not guaranteed, not guaranteed. Might as well go for guaranteed. Obliterated. Not enough to cause it not to have a thing, but that's okay. You took lead skill chance. I haven't actually used it. Maybe I should have taken versus human. Whatever. 4 to 7. These aren't actually good enough, which is annoying. Maybe I should do some bleed, because this will do bleed on top of the damage. On everything, even the corpse, which is already dead. So 3 damage to everyone. Now we start using... maybe this. Yes, because now we know they're going to get a go. So, we'd rather that one of them didn't, right? That seems to make the most sense. 3 to 8, 3 to 5. So, I think this unit. Oh, maybe the one closer to death, but it's stunned, so it's not going to get a go. So, we do get to hit it a second time later. 1 damage. So, that's dead. It just is delayed. No one dodged it, but whatever. debuff is less dodge. Meh. Right? Meh. Ooh! Okay, that was bad. But you are a healer, so you'll be alright. Okay. So now we want to start doing things like this. We could kill it. We did kill it. So that was a good move. Then pick to the face on this. Also kills it. This one only has one go left, so it will die. Everybody dodged it because that was a crap shot. You're rubbish. Everyone's stress heal. Da-da-da-da. It worked on the people I cared about it working on. And then you will heal yourself. Ta-da! And then it's as though we didn't arrive here in the first place. Good. Well done. Good day. Yeah, that was an okay fight. I mean, it could have been better, to be honest. That could have been a better fight. Oh, it's a fucking torch. Brilliant. You don't need a bandage. You need a torch. Shut the hell up. Erasmus, why are you at the front? Get there. Good. We could debuff ourselves, but... Again, whatever. We can leave at any time. I don't think we can leave in the middle of combat, but I'm happy to even take on this next combat. In fact, if we haven't had a hunger pang... I'm sorry, what were you saying? I was saying, thanks for asking, if we haven't had a hunger pang by the time we get to this, I'll just eat the food. But we have. So now I want to be able to have another one between those who's knowing this game, it will cause me to have another one between those two curios. And I will be sad. I'll be a very sad panda. Right, we'll go here, we'll fight the battle, get the loot from the battle, and then...
The light, the promise of safety.
It's books. Well, hopefully the other curio is worth it. Oh! Suitsy scores, back of the net. Cares. Everything's dead. Blossoms. Good. That was a very easy combat. More like that, please. Wish the level 3 combat was like that. Promises success. It does seem like the level 3s have been more than uncharacteristically difficult than they should be.
Glittering gold, well, trinkets and baubles.
I'm just going to leave.
Paid for in blood.
I mean, the difference in difficulty between the level 3 party and a level 3 dungeon, well, that's a level 2 party and a level 1 dungeon, but you get the idea. Level 4 party, level 3 dungeon, seems to be a bit too high a jump. Everyone got stuff and you got syphilis. Okay. Does that mean that you will only drink? Or does it mean that you will open the barrels in town? Which would make me a little bit sad. Indeed.
Trouble yourself not with the cost of this crusade. Its noble end affords you broad tolerance in your choice of means.
No. The fact I haven't got any money doesn't afford me any broad anything in my choice of means. Sort by name. We picked up one we don't want to keep. This one. Yes. Right, we're sort of back in the money, almost literally. We've only... Starting to sell ones that are of limited usefulness. There's a chance we'll get them back later, and there's a chance I won't give a toss later, so... Selling them is basically like we never picked them up in the first place. Except, we can do stuff. We've got 43 and we need 44. Oh, 33 here. That... It doesn't seem as useful as the blacksmith. But maybe it is. But it's a lot more expensive to make that exchange. So let's get the blacksmith upgraded in terms of stabby. So we'll change a thingy for a single deep. We'll upgrade stabby. We need 49 of them, but we've only got none, so that's a lot. So there's obviously no way we can afford to do this at this stage, but we can afford to do it later. I think I'm going to make that a short episode. I was half tempted to just do another quick run, but honestly, I think I'm going to not and leave it for the next episode when I might just take the same 4 people out, try and get them leveled up, try and get everyone else sort of in, like... See how they're going down slightly? eventually they will be available again, but I don't want to wait that long. If that makes sense. Which it does, because it was a very simple sentence. But I think it makes sense to not put them in, because if we put them in, they'll go down to maybe 3 pips. If we wait a while, start doing some low-level stuff, level these people up, it's still turning out to be useful. Then we could bring Sejiris along with these people on the level 3 mission, see how it gets on. But until the next episode, I'll thank you for watching this episode, and I'll see you then.